In this video, we will be highlighting two topics, the modular arithmetic and the modulo congruence. The concept of modular arithmetic was developed by Carl Friedrich Gauss in his book entitled "Die Sketches Arithmetici" in 1801 when he was only 24 years old. In mathematics, modular arithmetic, which is sometimes called as the clock arithmetic, is a system of arithmetic for integers where numbers wrap around after they reach a certain value, which is called as the modulus. Let us use a clock for example and replace 12 by 0. Starting from midnight, the hour hand points in order of the following: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 0. And as it reaches noontime, the hour hand points on the same order. And this is the way in which we count in modulo 12. Think of the modular arithmetic as that of the remainder in division, because the operation in finding the remainder is sometimes referred as the modulo operation. Suppose we divide an integer by 5. Of course, it will have the remainder 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4. If we divide an integer by 7, it will have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 as the remainder. And if we divide an integer by 10, it will have 0 to 9 as the remainder. Thus, we define z sub n, or an integer z divided by n, as the set of integers from 0 to n minus 1 modulo n. So we have z sub 3 is equal to the set of integers 0, 1, 2 modulo 3. Z sub 5 is equal to the set of integers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 modulo 5. Z sub 8 is the set of integers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 modulo 8. Note that z sub n has n non-negative integers, which are basically the integers from 0 to n minus 1. Consider that in z sub n, modulo is simply the remainder a when an integer b is divided by n. That is, if you divide b by n, it will have a remainder a which is less than n, since of course the value of a will be from 0 to n minus 1. We will write it as a is equal to b modulo n. Note that the parentheses may or may not be written. If we were asked to find 4 plus 9 in z sub 8, or in other words, if we divide by 8, what is the remainder of 4 plus 9 or 13? And that is 5. It is because 5 is the remainder when 13 is divided by 8. So we write 5 is equal to 13 modulo 8. In z sub 8, what is 15 plus 21? That is 4, since 15 plus 21 or 36 when divided by 8 gives us a remainder of 4. So we may write 4 is equal to 36 modulo 8. In z sub 15, meaning if we're going to divide by 15, what is 11 plus 12? That is 8. It's because 8 is the remainder when we divide 23 by 15. So we may write 8 is equal to 23 modulo 15. How about 106 plus 102 in z sub 10? That is 8. It is because 8 is the remainder when 208 or 106 plus 102 is divided by 10. So we may write 8 is equal to 208 modulo 10. In z sub 9, what is 22 minus 3? The answer is 1. It is because 1 is the remainder when 19 is divided by 9. Or in other words, when you keep on subtracting 9 from 19, and as you reach the numbers from 0 to 8, you will reach the number 1. So we may write 1 is equal to 19 modulo 9. How about in z sub 5, what is 3 minus 20? The answer is 3. You may keep on adding 5 with negative 17, and as you reach the numbers from 0 to 4, you will get 3. So we may write 3 is equal to negative 17 modulo 5. 11 times 5 when divided by 4, the remainder is 3. So we may write 3 is equal to 55 modulo 4. In z sub 11, what is 9 times 10? The answer is 2. It is because 2 is the remainder when 90 is divided by 11. Or in other words, subtracting 11 continuously from 90, and as you reach the numbers from 0 to 10, you will reach the number 2. Next, I'm going to show you is called the modulo table, wherein it will show that Z sub n is closed under binary operations of addition and multiplications of integers modulo n, wherein if we have Z sub 3, in which the values will only be 0, 1, and 2, and if we're going to perform addition, then 0 plus 0 will just be 0. 0 plus 1 will just be 1. 0 plus 2 is 2. 1 plus 0 would still be 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 2, as we know, is 3, but at modulo 3, that is 0. 2 plus 0 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. At modulo 3, that is 0. And 2 plus 2 is 4, and at modulo 3, that is just 1. Since all the values in the table, as we can see, are just composed of 0, 1, and 2, then we can say that it is closed under addition. Now let's try the multiplication. Still from Z sub 3, so all the values will be 0, 1, and 2. Starting with 0 times 0, so that is 0. 0 times 1 is 0. 0 times 2 is 0. 1 times 0 is still 0. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times 2 is 2. 2 times 0 is 0. 2 times 1 is 2. And 2 times 2 is 4, but at modulo 3, that is 1. And since similarly, all the values here are composed of 0, 1, and 2, then we can say that it is closed under multiplication. Next, we have the modulo congruence, which was although pioneered by Leonhard Euler in 1750, it was developed by Carl Friedrich Gauss in 1801. The modulo congruence, which is written as, is read as A is congruent to B modulo n. Do not be confused with the modular arithmetic that uses the equal sign. Remember that congruence uses this symbol. We say that A is congruent to B modulo n when A and B have the same remainder when divided by n. So remember here that A is not necessarily the remainder when B is divided by n, unlike in the modular arithmetic. It is just A and B must have the same remainder when divided by n. To illustrate, suppose we have n equals 8. That is, Z sub 8 is equal to the set of integers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 modulo 8. Similarly, this may be represented by a circle like a clock with 8 divisions, starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And if we continue counting, 8 will have the same position as 0, 9 will have the same position as 1, 10 will have the same position as 2, and 11 will have the same position as 3, and so on as we continue counting. Similarly, if we're going to count backwards, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, negative 1 will have the same position as 7. Negative 2 will have the same position as 6. Negative 3 will have the same position as 5. And negative 4 will have the same position as 4. And we may continue counting backwards. So given this illustration, we can say that 22 is congruent to 14 modulo 8. It is because 22 and 14 have the same remainder 6 when divided by 8. Similarly, we may say that 26 is congruent to 10 modulo 8. It is because 26 and 10 have the same remainder, which is 2 when divided by 8. And likewise, negative 5 is congruent to 19 modulo 8. It is because negative 5 and 19 both have the same remainder, which is 3, when divided by 8. Now, we may also say that A is congruent to B modulo n if n divides A minus B, which may be written in this form. Or in other words, A minus B is a multiple of n. So, we can see here that 22 minus 14 is a multiple of 8, since 22 minus 14 is 1 times 8. Similarly, 26 minus 10 is a multiple of 8, since 26 minus 10 is 2 times 8. And negative 5 minus 19 is a multiple of 8, since negative 5 minus 19 is negative 3 times 8. So as long as there's an integer k which when multiplied to n gives us a minus b, then a is congruent to b modulo n. Or in other words, as long as a minus b all over n is equal to k and k is an integer, then a is congruent to b modulo n. True or false, is 29 congruent to 8 modulo 3? True, since 29 and 8 have the same remainder 2 when divided by 3. Or in other words, 29 minus 8 divided by 3 gives us an integer, which is 7. How about 15 is congruent to 4 modulo 6? False, because 15 and 4 have different remainders when divided by 6. 15 has a remainder of 3, while 4 is already the remainder when divided by 6. Or simply 15 minus 4 divided by 6 is 1 and 5 over 6, which is not an integer. 37 is congruent to 9 modulo 7. True, because 37 and 9 have the same remainder, which is 2 when divided by 7. Or 37 minus 9 when divided by 7 gives us 4, which is an integer. Now, which of this is true and which of this is false? Negative 17 is congruent to 10 modulo 3 is true. Likewise, 85 is congruent to negative 5 modulo 9 is also true. But 80 is congruent to 12 modulo 8 is false. Now let's have equations involving modulo congruence. Suppose we have 3x plus 5 is congruent to 3 at modulo 4. And for us to solve this equation, all we have to do is to try different values of x. Whatever are the values of x that satisfy the congruence, then those are the solutions to this equation. So let's try when x is 0. So that's 3 times 0 plus 5, is it congruent to 3 modulo 4? Or in other words, is 5 congruent to 3 modulo 4? And it's actually not. How about when x is equal to 1? So that's 3 times 1 plus 5, is it congruent to 3 modulo 4? Or can we say that 8 is congruent to 3 at modulo 4? And still, actually, it's not. How about when x is 2? Is 3 times 2 plus 5 congruent to 3 modulo 4? In other words, is 11 congruent to 3 modulo 4? And yes, 11 is congruent to 3 at modulo 4. Now what if x is equal to 3? Is 3 times 3 plus 5 congruent to 3 modulo 4? Or can we say that 14 is congruent to 3 modulo 4? And it's actually not. How about when x is 4? Is 3 times 4 plus 5 or 17 congruent to 3 modulo 4? Still, the answer is no. If x is equal to 5, then 3 times 5 plus 5, is it congruent to 3 modulo 4? Or is 20 congruent to 3 modulo 4? Similarly, the answer is no. And when we try x equals 6, so that's 3 times 6 plus 5, or 23, is it equal to 3 modulo 4? And the answer is yes. And when we try x equals 7, x equals 8, x equals 9, expectedly, those are not congruent to 3 modulo 4. And when we try x equals 10, that will be congruent to 3 modulo 4. So we can say that 2, 6, 10, and so on are some of the solutions to this equation. And since this is a sequence of numbers with difference of 4, expectedly 14, 18, 22, and so on are still solutions to this equation. Now let's try another equation, which is 2x plus 1 congruent to 3 modulo 10. I hope you got 1, 6, 11 are some of the solutions to this equation. Since when x equals 1, x equals 6, and x equals 11, when substituted to 2x plus 1, that gives us congruence to 3 modulo 10. And since likewise, this is a sequence of number with difference of 5, then expectedly 16, 21, 26, and so on are also solutions to this equation. Now let's have some properties of the modulo congruence. The first one is the reflexive property, which states that a is congruent to a modulo n, which tells us that any integer a at modulo n will be congruent to the same integer a. Next, the symmetric property, which states that if a is congruent to b modulo n, then b is congruent to a modulo n, which shows that a and b here are interchangeable. The transitive property, which states that if A is congruent to B modulo n and B is congruent to C modulo n, then A is congruent to C modulo n. Now let's have the additive inverse, in which in Z sub n, two numbers A and B are additive inverse of each other if A plus B is congruent to 0 modulo n. So if we're asked to find the additive inverse of 7 in modulo 16, then that gives us 9. It's because 7 plus 9 is congruent to 0 modulo 16. If we're asked to find the additive inverse of 2 in modulo 12, that gives us 10. It's because 2 plus 10 is congruent to 0 modulo 12. If we have negative 4 in modulo 5, that gives us 4. It's because negative 4 plus 4 is congruent to 0 modulo 5. If we're asked to find the additive inverse of 11 in modulo 9, that gives us 7. It's because 11 plus 7 is congruent to 0 modulo 9. Or in other words, 18 is congruent to 0 modulo 9. If we're asked to find the additive inverse of 5 in modulo 7, that gives us 2. It's because 5 plus 2 or 7 is congruent to 0 modulo 7. Next, we have the multiplicative inverse, which states that in Z sub n, two numbers A and B are multiplicative inverse of each other if A times B is congruent to 1 modulo n. So if we're asked to find the multiplicative inverse of 5 in Z sub 7, then that gives us 3. It's because 5 times 3, which is 15, has a remainder of 1 when divided by 7, or in other words, 15 is congruent to 1 modulo 7. If we're asked to find the multiplicative inverse of 3 in modulo 10, the answer is 7. It's because 3 times 7, which is 21, is congruent to 1 modulo 10, or in other words, 21 has a remainder of 1 when divided by 10. But if we are asked to find the multiplicative inverse of 4 in modulo 6, that will give us no answer because there's no number when multiplied to 4 gives us congruence to 1 modulo 6. Or in other words, there is no number when multiplied to 4 and divided by 6 gives us a remainder of 1.
Note that every number has an additive inverse but not necessarily a multiplicative inverse. Consider that modular arithmetic and modulo congruence are foundations in many areas of mathematics like number theory, and are used extensively in areas like group theory and abstract algebra. While in applied mathematics, they are used in cryptography, computer science, chemistry, and even in the visual and musical arts. Now, this ends our topic in the modular arithmetic and modulo congruence. If you happen to like this video, do not forget to click like, subscribe, and hit the bell button so that you will be updated in the upcoming videos.